This is the day the Lord hath made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I will now read from the book of Psalms. I will praise the Lord, O Lord, with my whole heart. I shall show thy forth thy marvelous works. Psalm 2. I will be glad to rejoice with thee. I will sing praises to thy name, thou most high. Psalms 9 through 1.
Hello, brothers and sisters. This is the Reverend Paul D. Boyd, and I have a message for you. God has told me that someone out there needs to hear this message, so God has entrusted me to give you this message. First of all, someone out there right now is having a troubled time. Someone out there is going through something really hard. Someone is going through something that they think that they can't overcome, something that feels impossible for them to beat. But with God, all things are possible. And sometimes you feel like you're alone. You feel like God's not there. But God is always there. Jesus died on that cross for you. So no matter what sin you did, no matter how far you feel or you're away from God, God is always there. So he's never going to let you go. Sometimes you say, why, God, how come my life seems so shaken up? Well, you know what? You're shaking because you're in the hand of God. This is the hand's God. And you're in there. And sometimes he has to shake it. Shake the hand. So that you realize that you're still in the hand of God. In the presence of the Lord. And of whatever God you believe in. But the central God is always there. Never leaves you behind. He's not going to leave you to your vices or your addictions or your problems. Or no matter what you're going through, God is always there. And he knows what your limits are. Like this says one time, it says in the book there, that God never gives you more than you can handle. And that is the very truth. You may think you're at your limit, but God knows what your limit is. And he's not going to let anything go beyond that. His hand will not be able to hold you there. If you start feeling your final way and you feel the grip is leaving you, he's not going to grab you tighter and bring you back. So just remember that God is always there. When Daniel was in the lion's den, and the lions were there attacking Daniel, what God did is he gave Daniel the strength to beat the lions. He gave Daniel the strength to come through that ordeal. And in the end, Daniel was stronger. And Daniel fought these beasts that he thought he could not beat on his own. He thought that he had his limit. But God knew what his limit was. And God showed him the way. And we see that so much throughout history. We see David and Goliath. This giant, huge giant that was like terrorizing people. And it was a giant. And all the soldiers and all the men and who were there fighting were terrified of this giant coming at them and terrorizing their village and terrorizing them and their homes and everything. And they had all these spears and they had shields and they had all this kind of armor, but they were rattling and shaking. When they were out there in the field with David there, they were behind the line. They were shaking. They were terrified of this giant. And this David, this little... You know, he wasn't a real warrior type. He just was a, you know, an ordinary shepherd, I guess they say he was. And he took this sling and put a rock in it and boom, knocked Goliath down. And these Goliaths in your life will be knocked down by the simplest thing. Simplest tools. And the tools, you may not think you have them, but God has the tools. God has what it takes to make you strong. God has what it takes for you to beat the lion. In the lion den. God has what has a sling and the rock, and he knows what will take the giant down. And there's no giant in this world, there is no object in this world, no addiction, no problem in this world that God will not help you through it. So just remember one thing, this is the message for you from God. God has sent me to send you this message, and that message is, don't be afraid. Remember, God is always with you. It says in the book, if God is behind me, then no one shall be against me. And that is the absolute truth. God will always be there. Do not give up hope. Do not feel afraid, because you will not be afraid, because God is there with you. God is in control. The game belongs to God. It's like the controllers and everything. You're playing this game, Pac-Man, or you're playing some kind of new 3D realm game, or you're going through all these things. But the game actually isn't controlled. You might see these objects that are there, but these games aren't random. They are controlled. They're designed by computer programmers, and people that are into technology have designed this game. It's all a map. It's all designed and programmed by someone, and that someone who programs your life is God. And the book that teaches you how to learn that programming, the book that shows you how to live your life, how to follow the teachings and know what the master's plans are, is called the Holy Bible. There are other books you could call the other religions of faith, the Quran, the Book of Death. There's all kinds of other books, but the central book, the central message is there's one true God, and that true God may have many names, but the true God is the only Messiah, and He is the master of the entire universe and the master of all the planets. So don't worry, don't be afraid. When you feel weak and you feel like you're at your end, it's only a trial. It's only being shaken up. You're still in the hand of God. And He's still there holding you tight, protecting you from everything in this world. And when you feel shaken up and life seems to be falling apart, it's only God's there right now. God is always there. He's never going to let you fall out of His hands. He's going to hold you there. You're in the hands of God. And He will always protect you. And whenever you feel weak, when you feel, my God, God, I'm near the end. I don't know what I'm going to do. I've done so much wrong. I've done so much bad. Well, don't worry, because God knows what your plan is. He knows what He has for you. And you just follow His ways. The more you have fear, the more you turn to Him, and the stronger you will become. So be fearless, my friend. Who out there who needs this message, who needs the help? The help that comes from above. So ask for God's help. When you feel weak, you feel strong, afraid, or you can't do it, you can't wake up tomorrow. If you feel you can't quit that addiction, you can't quit that alcohol, the drugs, the marijuana, the eating, smoking, all kinds of other addictions. Or you can't seem to fight your abusive behavior if you're abusive at home. You can fight them. You can fight all this. There is nothing to be afraid of. Remember, God is always there. And that's my message to you from Reverend Paul D. Boyd. Thank you for tuning in and have a great day.